Hey everyone, this is my Pegasus. It's a piece that I did a few years ago. Not that long ago, but it is one of my favorite pieces actually. Like the way it turned out. Like the way the wings turned out and the background. Some other artists have said that horses are notoriously difficult to draw or to paint. And I've always loved wild horses, mythological creatures. Obviously, Pegasus has wings, so it's not just a wild horse, but it's similar, right? I love them as an archetype for freedom. Freedom. Something that I have seen so little of in this realm, in this lifetime. And I noticed it as a young boy, that people are not free. They're not free spirits. I've always wanted to fly and run wild, excuse me, run wild like a, like a wild horse, okay? So they, for me, they're an archetype for freedom. Something that is so lacking in this realm. So, so very lacking. So incredibly lacking in this realm. And it's shameful when you think about it. It's sad. But I don't want people to get depressed. That's the counterpoint. Okay? I want to counterbalance this with hope, okay? Real hope, not hopium, not wishful thinking, not, oh, we're gonna all live as one heaven for all, and all this religious bullshit. I don't push that at all, obviously. I know how false it is, but I think that we have reason to hope. I think that we are free spirits and that we will be free one day, okay? And it's going to be beautiful and glorious outside of this place. Think of it this way. Do prison guards in a maximum security prison work all day long, day and night, shift after shift, three shifts per 24 hours, let's say 8-hour shifts, to deceive and trick the inmates, to keep them there? No, they rely on the bars, the cages, the locks, the alarms, the security system, the walls, the fences, the razor wire, whatever they have, the guard towers. If it's a prison, it's a prison, and it's clearly a prison. The inmates know it, the guards know it, the guards are paid, they're aware, but there's no trickery going on. It's not like, hey, we have to fool them to keep them in here, make them think that they're not in a prison. But that's what's happening here in this realm. They rely on that. They rely on illusions, trickery, deceptions, just like those Star Trek episodes that I showed and I analyzed over the months here. Various ones. I've shown that. And that's a truth drop in science fiction. That's how this place actually works. So when you think of it that way, why would they have to do that? We're not sealed in here forever, okay? And we're aware of how this realm works. We see what it is. We see it as it is. We don't try to change it into something in our minds and pretend that it's something that it's not. We're not in denial. We're not under religious mind control. We're not brainwashed. We're not enslaved to religion or enslaved to government or enslaved to false New Age gurus or whatever, right? We're free spirits, we're free thinkers and critical thinkers. So, right there, right off the bat, you have tremendous reason for real hope. Might be closer to figuring this whole fucking thing out than humans have been for centuries, for generations. That's the way it seems, doesn't it? at least here on my channels. Can't speak for the entire internet or the entire realm of all of humanity, but the ones here on my channel, okay? Go back to Pegasus for a moment. He can run, he can fly, strong, he's free-spirited. Take a look at that piece. I'm self-taught. I didn't sit down in a classroom and somebody teach me or tell me what to do, to tell me how to draw. I can look at a statue and make a sketch or look at whatever, and sometimes it's just from pure imagination, and I can draw. Okay? I'm not boasting. I'm saying this for a reason. We have abilities that they don't want us to ever, ever, ever know about. They want you to feel limited. They want you to feel stupid. They want you to feel small. They want you to feel powerless, including these religious fuckheads that will say, oh, Stephen's preaching despair. He's negative. He's pessimistic. I think choosing freedom is the ultimate thing. They're the ones that are pessimistic. They're the ones that want to be slaves to some fake savior that never comes. Okay? That's negative. That's stupid. That's slave think. That's giving in to despair. That's quitting on yourself. And I'll never do that. Do you understand? I've said it before, and I'll say it again. I'll fight forever if I have to be free. I'll never settle for slavery. That's in my spirit. I'm one of those spirits that they cannot control. They cannot control me. Okay? It is impossible to control my rebellious spirit. Impossible. And I will do everything within my power to help good spirits get free from this trick, this trap, this fake-ass sewer matrix system. And I do believe that they're hiding tremendous beauty, perhaps beyond our imagination, outside of here, that they don't want you to ever, ever, ever know about. Because if you knew about it, that would be even way more motivation to say, you know what? This place sucks. This place is a sewer. This place stinks. This place is unfair. This place is evil. This place is full of suffering. This whole realm is rigged. The harder I work, the harder life is. I mean, I just get rewarded by punishment if I help others and I get this and that. And this place is fucked. The deck is stacked against us specifically. There are different rules here for different beings. It's not all the same. And we're not all the same. Okay? And which is another false thing they teach us. All the same. We're all equal. We're all one. All that is bullshit. All of it. Okay? All of it. All of it is bullshit. We're not all one. Oneness would just be another prison. More slavery. Okay? That's what it would be. You'd be giving up your individuality, your personal identity, everything. Be like the Borg and just assimilate it. That sounds like another hell to me. Okay? But anyway, I want to go in the positive direction here. I do get worked up about that because I want to fight them. Okay? But I get worked up about hell, injustice, suffering, all that stuff because it's so wrong. But looking forward, I do think we're going to find places, realms, you might say. And they're not really realms, though. It's hard to describe, but I don't think they're like physical places. So when people think of a realm, they think, you know, of a earth, like a something with terra firma that you can walk on, stand on, build houses on, roads, whatever, right? They think of a world, or they think of a galaxy, or they think, I think it's different than that out there. That's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking it might be very different out there. And it might be, well, and not only might be, I do think it will be glorious and beautiful and magnificent. Probably beyond our wildest dreams. So the video went dark there into the blackness, right? And that kind of makes me think of the void and how peaceful people describe that as. And that's just within the matrix. That's still on the astral realm level, okay? Before that light comes that is euphoric and it's brainwashing. It's brainwashing with a love drug, a love bomb, a frequency weapon is what I probably, is what I think it probably is. Some type of love frequency weapon. A matrix weapon, an AI type of weapon, something that is false love. It's not true love, false euphoria. To lure you in with that bait and that good feeling. Anyway, we're in the blackness now. We're in the dark. We're in the dark, people, in the dark, as Chiron the Lost would say, his videos. So we're going to get nice and peaceful, nice and calm here. Nice and calm. It's been quite a day for me, so had a lot on my mind and covered a lot of different things. And there's always attacks from these little trolls, these little Christians and different religions and atheists and scammers and shills and sex offenders and violent threats. And there's all this stuff going on YouTube. You notice though, like with their smear campaigns and threats and ganging up, and I'm still here. It's trying to censor me, trying to shut my channel down. Why do you think they're trying so hard, all these people, trying so hard to get rid of me, to get rid of the Sanity Machine channel, to get rid of my other channels? Why do you think that is? Why do you think that is? Some of it's jealousy, of course, but I think they're fearful. They know I'm dangerous when it comes to having dangerous truth. It's opening gates, gateways, and people are going to be able to free themselves. One day, okay? One day. I'm not telling anybody to do what these idiots try to accuse me of, saying my message leads to that. It doesn't lead to that at all. My message is self-empowerment. To choose freedom, to choose the truth, to see what this realm is truly, with true eyes and true ears, to see with eyes to see, to hear with ears to hear, to use your spiritual discernment, your intuition, your gut feeling, all of these tools, your minds. Don't get rid of any tool just because they demonize it, like Chiron the Lost says. The mind is evil incarnate, and they want you to have less tools. They want you to be disabled and limited. I want you to be empowered and firing on all cylinders. Okay? You get what I'm saying? Think of a 500 horsepower supercar with 16 cylinders, and you're just fucking firing on all cylinders. You've got your heart and empathy working, but you also have your mind and your discernment and your spirit, and it's all working, okay? You have it all working for you. Not afraid to use what you are, okay? To recognize the truth, to spot the frauds, to spot the demons, to spot the liars, the shills, archons, whatever, right? Whatever. Whatever comes in your way. Psychos. There's a lot out there. There's a lot out there than many people realize. I mean, it's more common than people think. It really is. I want you to use your abilities. Develop them. Hone your skills. And to realize, chances are, it's not worse beyond here. It's probably, by all indications of what we go through and how they try to trick us and keep us here, it's probably amazing, magnificent, glorious, beautiful. It's probably gorgeous things to explore, to feel, to be in a state of being beyond here. Without work, without money, without pain and, without pain and struggling every day for survival, where we basically have to put ourselves in this realm through hell. And it's it's an awful place. It's a it's a really terrible place. That doesn't mean to lose hope, to give in to despair or hopelessness. I'm not saying that at all. I'm just saying out there it's probably way different than here. Probably way, way different than in here. That's why they don't want anybody to even think that it might be way better. They want spirits to settle for shit. Put it simply, that's what they want. And they use trickery, deception, illusions, lies, frauds, agents of the Matrix. They use everything they possibly can so that people won't stop and think, what if there's way better out there? What if there's so much more to explore? What if this is just a tiny little fucking hell realm? Like a black cube sitting on some ugly creature's desk. This simulation. What if that's the case? The way I see it, true freedom involves getting free from this matrix. I mean that in the deepest, deepest, most spiritual way that I can say it. In other words, I don't think I can be truly free here. I can't speak for you. I was going to say that we, but I won't use the small letter we or the capital we and speak for a collective or all of humanity. I can't be free here. Okay? I don't think I can. I've tried my whole life. I am a free spirit and a free-minded being. And I'm kind of eccentric and artistic and live as an artist, and I will die as an artist, not as a slave, okay? Can't really be physically free here. No matter where I live, I'm going to have aches and pains and all the stuff that the body goes through. You have to feed the body and the meat suit, and you have to do all things, maintenance things to take care of it. So even just on that level, and mentally, I mean, how can you be free in this fucking... this hell? Some would say, well, detach from it, just, you know. Well, then how do you care about others? Because I don't want to lose my care for others. I don't want to shut off my empathy and become that detached. That's not me, okay? It's not me to be like that. So I'm not going to become something that I'm not. If anything, I'm going to fight to keep myself, keep my identity, keep who I am, and never let them take that away or change me. That's another form of slavery and submission, and I won't allow that. What if it's a million times better beyond here? Then how powerful and hopeful and empowering would my message in all my videos be, explaining what this place is, if one day you find out, you know, I got out of the matrix, and you're saying to yourself, out of the matrix, wow, like beyond a wow, just astonishment that you can create these amazing things outside of here, and then you're glad beyond words that you chose to take that risk, to get out of here, to choose freedom, one day. Not talking about now. I think I learn more every day and every week. So there are some reasons to stick around here and keep learning and learning and learning and not cut your time short, or, you know, who knows, a week or a month from now, I might discover something massive and major. I might come upon something, or just might have an insight that just comes to me, or suddenly another puzzle piece fits where it's a big piece. And more of it opens up, and I'm able to see way more of the big picture. There are reasons, okay? So don't let these evil demons try to convince you what to do, ever, ever. No masters, no priests, No leaders, no gurus. All right? I've told people I want to be like a friendly hand or someone that's trying to help others, you could say. In some ways, some people have said they kind of see me as a big brother, older brother, protective of them, subscribers I'm talking about on my channel that I'm very friendly with, that get along great with and stuff and share with and stuff like that. Yes, I realize I've never met them in person, and they've never met me, I'm aware of that, but I can usually tell the good ones at a distance, okay? And the ones that have gone through shit in life and didn't deserve it. You all don't deserve that, what you've gone through here. Grieving the loss of loved ones, pets, family members, friends maybe, that have passed, and it hurt to see them suffer. Painful. This realm is designed to set up pain. So when these idiots, these demons talk about, well, he's in pain, his artwork's full of pain. Pegasus is not full of pain. Pegasus is not full of pain or despair, sadness or grief or darkness or evil or anything, quote, Freemasonic that these assholes try to accuse me of. It's full of hope and freedom, a message of freedom taking flight. Pegasus is glorious, and glorious as an archetype, as something to look to and remember in your dark times, and think to yourself, I'm going to be more like Pegasus. I'm not going to be grounded to this fucking hell realm prison. I'm going to be more like Pegasus and take flight. They can't hold me down here. Okay? So don't ever give in to the fear or despair or think that you're, quote, stuck here. You're not stuck here. Okay? This place is full of tricks and illusions trying to keep you here, trying to make you believe that there's higher authorities or higher spiritual authorities. It's all bullshit. It's all bullshit. You're going to be able to fly one day. Think of that. Think about that. Don't let this place get your hopes down, make your heart fall or sink, make your heart harden like a stone. Get your spirit down, because it's going to be amazing. You're going to discover things about yourself that you aren't aware of, and that maybe you can't really become fully aware of within this matrix system. But one day you will be. How glorious that's going to be. Just visualize that. Think about it. Think about the feeling, whatever you can do in your mind until your head basically feels high, thinking about, I'm going to be feeling so free. So free. So incredibly free. Where it'll be like weights falling away from you. Chains snapping right off of you. Even though we're not enslaved like the others here, that basically fight to remain enslaved by all the systems here. Materialism, politics, Hollywood, the demonic systems here, money, the stock market, fake elections, fake everything here, fake food, fake religion, fake spirituality, fake new age, fake gurus, everything here is fucking fake. And the lies, the media, mainstream media, it's endless. I could go on forever just naming everything that's fake here. There's almost nothing real here. So how good is it going to feel to be out of here, right? It's going to be amazing. It's going to be amazing. There's going to be adventures. There's going to be beauty, peace, and you won't have to worry about hunger or eating or worry about starving or worry about bills or worry about becoming homeless or worried about this or worried about that. All these worries. I mean, it starts in childhood. They try to program us to worry about tests and exams and school and worry about missing the school bus and worrying about getting up on time for school and not, not being up too late and not sleeping in and worry about this and that and teacher-parent interviews and what the teacher's going to say and blah, 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 and, you know, worry about coming home and getting, you know, hit by your abusive alcoholic parent or this or that. There's so much, right? There's so much. It's just endless in this realm. But it isn't going to be that way. See what I'm saying? It isn't going to be that way outside of here. It's going to be completely different. And that's why all of this is important. I wouldn't be doing it if it didn't matter. I wouldn't be making hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of videos and spending all this time, effort, thought, energy to share and to try to reach others and try to bring them to my channel, to make them aware, to spread the word. I spend a lot of time doing that every week, every month. I'm trying to find people on other channels where they're stuck somewhere and I'm trying to help them, because I know if they watch a few of my videos, it's all in that hypnotic voice, right? That's what it's like. It might be the message, and it might be the meat. It might be the meat of the message, right? It's all in the meat, Kurt Cobain said one time in a interview. Nirvana was interviewed, Much Music in Toronto. It's all in the meat. It's all in the meat. Trying to ask him what the meaning was. Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is. Not in the soy. Okay, it's not in the soy. It's not in the soy. Answers are not in veganism. So, that's what I wanted to talk about tonight. That's what I wanted to talk about tonight. Hope this reaches you. And I hope you realize that things are going to get better. Maybe not in this realm, but this is temporary. We're not trapped here forever. We're not sealed here forever. Evil, or Team Evil, would love for us to believe that. They'd love for us to feel hopeless and powerless and doomed and reliant on some fake savior that never comes. Why aren't you waiting around for a savior? Why aren't you focused on shit that doesn't happen rather than making yourself stronger and more aware and use your own mind, spirit, intuition, discernment, spiritual abilities, psychic abilities as well. If they were that powerful, it wouldn't be run this way. This system, they wouldn't rely on illusions, trickery, lies, deceptions, all that weak shit. It's all Wizard of Oz, the little man behind the curtain, right? The little wizard pulling the levers, pushing the buttons, and the little dog Toto pulled back the curtain to expose him. Innocent little dog used his instincts and intuition to look behind the curtain. There's a message there that can help you. Right? full of giants, and they're not full of mental giants. You just see it by the way they are, the way they behave, the way these systems here behave. They work pretty hard not to get discovered. They want to make themselves appear big and powerful. They set themselves up as the authority figures in this realm and in the astral realm, those creatures over there. They're fakes, they're frauds. They get triggered easily. They're not nearly as aware as they pretend to be, and they want you to believe. They're fake. And I'm showing that. I'm pulling their masks off on YouTube, but it goes beyond YouTube. We'll be able to do that out of our bodies. That's what I'm saying. That's just good practice here. It's just good practice to do that, to expose them, to take their masks off and say, look at this weak little creature. Look at this creepy little creature behind this mask. It's trying to make everyone believe that they were big and bad and scary, and they're running scared. I can take 10, 12, 20 on at once. No problem here. No problem. You've seen it already. You're seeing it happen. It's going to be the same thing outside of here, out of body, in the spiritual realms. Come at me with a legion of them, 200. I'll take them all on. I'm not afraid. I'm stronger. And I'm aware of that. It's not just, oh, he's so confident. Or, you know, some people say, well, Stephen just has the confidence and, you know, we don't. Or, you know, well, why not? How come you're not confident? Want all good spirits hearing my voice to have that confidence in yourself, in your abilities. They're going to try to scare you, but why would you be scared of them? They're weaklings. They're fakes. They're hiding behind a mask, hiding behind technology. I don't just mean on YouTube. I mean these creatures, shapeshifters, imposters, demons, archons, whatever you want to call them, in the other realms, the astral realm, and, you know, the realms that we don't have the visual spectrum to see in these human meat suits with our eyes. But they're there. They're cowards. They're weak. They're liars. They rely on lies and deceptions and shape-shifting. You get what I'm saying? They're not strong. They're not powerful. They use illusions, just like at that Star Trek episode where it tried to make the Captain Pike believe that it was a monster. On top of it in that room, forced it to shut off its power of illusion. It's illusions. They have the illusion of power, the illusion of strength. It doesn't mean that the evil we're combating or going to combat are more powerful than we are. It doesn't mean that at all. Wouldn't rely on all this shit if they were more powerful. They'd be way more direct and blatant and overt about it. They wouldn't have to use illusions and stealth and trickery and set up all these mind games and system after system and all these Easter eggs and rabbit holes. And it's endless here. It's just endless. It's a huge maze, labyrinth, whatever you want to call it, of deceptions. Mind fuck you, and to make you feel small, to make you feel defeated, to get you confused and lost, to degrade you, to get you thinking there's no way out, to lose hope. All designed to do that. And what I'm saying is, it's failing. We're winning. We're seeing through it. All right? We're seeing through it. And we're powerful. And we're going to have freedom. We're going to have beauty. We are eternal beings. I know that I am, for sure. I'm going to have freedom. I'm going to have beauty. I'm going to have adventures. It's going to be glorious and amazing. I'm not down. I'm not about despair. Not at all. So thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Take care, everyone. Bye.